This video is brought to you by Alibaba.com.
Top power loader, but first, coffee. In the last episode of the power loader series, we finished fabricating the left arm and started working on the design for the back and the shoulders in order to get the full range of motion of the power loader. In this episode, we're gonna finish the design, fabricate everything, and hopefully get the power loader onto the test stand. So here we have the finished design of the deltoid plate. This part will actually mount onto the side of the bicep with this face here. It'll bolt on with 12 half inch screws. And then it's got a few round pieces to hold the cylinder head, as well as a few ribs to ensure that the whole thing doesn't bend under pressure. So we should be good to build it. All right, so we're back in the shop and there's lots to do, so let's get to it. We have to fabricate the shoulders, grind some stuff, weld a bunch of stuff, fit it all together, and stuff.
It'll be fun.
It'll be fun. Here's the actual shoulder piece for the Alias power loader, and it's one of the most critical pieces to get right because it will actually join two of the axes together. In reference to the model, it actually combines this back piece here as well as the top linkage there and a very large hydraulic cylinder, which has a 5-inch bore capable of outputting almost 60,000 pounds of force. Now, this is critical that we do a stress analysis on this part because that's a lot of force and we do not want the part to deform or break under the full load. So the stress analysis just finished and we can see that is a problem. That red there signifies that the material is taking way more load than it's capable. And that would cause some serious deformation and likely a failure of the entire shoulder. We're gonna have to make some changes in the design to ensure that doesn't happen. All right, so I beefed up the material on the side walls. Unfortunately, while that's a lot better, it's still not ideal. We're gonna need a different solution. So I just got back from metal supermarkets and asked their opinion on the design. And they had a really good suggestion. Why not try a better type of steel? So let's load that up into the SOLIDWORKS model and see if we can get some better results. Okay, well that looks a lot more promising. So let's get that steel on order and continue building this power loader.
That's your plate, that's the Aero 400.
Very nice, and you said that this was how many times stronger than A36?
Four times stronger.
Four times stronger.
It's strong as hell and it's gonna stop the bullet.
So now that we have the whole design completed, we can start working on the box tube, as that's kind of the core of the entire design, and getting that completed will put us on a really good trajectory for completing the power loader shoulders. Does that look straight to you? This is straight. Now that every piece of the design is fully fabricated, we're gonna test fit everything to ensure that all pieces move nicely, and then we're gonna send it out for painting.
Hey, it's me, the Hacksmith. You might have noticed I haven't been in too many of the videos lately. Have I been off on a yacht enjoying all that YouTube money? I wish. No, I do actually spend a lot of time at work, like 60 to 80 hours a week. I basically live here. I've just been working on the business, not the videos, or even the project, sadly. The Power Loader project was my dream project idea from 4 years ago. In fact, I announced it publicly the day I met Bogdan at the GTA Expo in 2016. Bogdan's since taken over the project, and I couldn't be more proud of what him and our team has accomplished so far. It really is incredible. But as you know, building a giant mech on YouTube, it's rather expensive. And not to point fingers, but another YouTube channel literally went bankrupt building a mech. And we don't want that to happen, right? I want to see this project through to completion as much as you guys. That's why I'm really happy to announce this video's sponsor, a company you all know and one that we've been using for years now as a business, Alibaba.com. Alibaba.com is a leading end-to-end online platform for global business-to-business trade. They provide a platform for manufacturers all around the world to discover new opportunities in business. With payment terms, pay later features, and Alibaba.com freight, you can rest assured that you're getting the best price on the products and equipment you need for your business to succeed. Like I said, we've been using the platform for years. I ordered my original CNC laser cutter off of Alibaba.com, which helped me start this YouTube channel and business 7 years ago. All these LED lights in our new facility, we saved thousands of dollars ordering them from a supplier in China off Alibaba.com. In fact, the sales team even came to visit us in Canada to make sure we were happy. We recently got a hydro massage table for our employees. Can you guess? Yep, we ordered it from a company in South Korea off Alibaba.com. This month is March Expo 2020 for Alibaba.com. There's over 35,000 featured global suppliers with over 300,000 new products, upgrade logistics, finance, and payment services. As part of March Expo, we just got this awesome thermal camera from Maca off Alibaba.com. It has a big 2.4-inch display, you can even save images off USB, and it has quick image refresh, as well as 300,000 HD pixels, so you can see exactly what's heating up. Plus, there's tons of other great products, like 3D printers from the supplier Anut, or even a giant laser cutter from the manufacturer Bodor. Learn more and check out March Expo on Alibaba.com today and discover new opportunities using links in the description below.
We're gonna try to put the side shoulders on and then put the biceps on to see how the whole thing moves together and make sure we got appropriate clearance everywhere. Why did you give me the heavy side, Chris?
You always give me the heavy side.
No, you always take the heavy side. Watch your fingers. And that goes on here, and you should be able to do this.
It's like a giant slab of meat.
That's gonna be something.
We can lift the bed if you want.
And then there's a notch to align as well.
There's what?
This notch must be aligned to that notch.
Oh, you stopped filming for just a moment?
For bug and safety, I cannot stop filming.
Pipe to go in?
Yep.
For filming's sake, I would love for you guys to attach the other arm, but for sanity's sake, I could understand why you wouldn't want to in this very moment.
I'm fine attaching the other one. Who's with me?
Let's do this.
Now all we have to do is install that piece with the fingers, which is 400 pounds alone each. So we gotta add another 800 pounds to this thing. And then we get to add all the side plates, all the hydraulics, all the hoses, all the decorational pieces. It's gonna be a fun Monday.
Big thank you to Alibaba.com for sponsoring this video. All right, it is fantastic to see the power loader coming together. It is freaking huge. We've got both arms and the shoulders mounted to the body now. The next step is adding the hydraulics and doing a test to make sure everything moves as we thought it would in our SOLIDWORKS design. Make sure you subscribe so you're not gonna wanna miss the next episode.